So not long ago, I wrote a book about identity called Hello, My Name Is, and every chapter kind of talked about different identities that we take on or that have been handed to us and the ones that might keep us from really discovering the true freedom of finding our identity wholly in Christ. And one of the things that I wrote about that might have hit closest to home for me was a section called Hello, My Name Is Professional Christian. I've learned that it's possible to get more concerned about looking the part than living the part, to be more concerned about appearance than what's actually going on inside. I say I'm fine, yeah, I'm fine, oh, I'm fine, hey, I'm fine, but I'm not, I'm broken. Isaiah talks about it where it says, you know, these people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. And if I'm being honest, that's described my story too many times. I'm really good at proclaiming my faith in Christ, but am I really pursuing a passionate relationship with Him? We do that all the time. We play that game all the time. And meanwhile, we leave church and then we hear about so-and-so who had a moral failure. We hear about a marriage that ended. We hear about a kid who's being bullied and had nobody to talk to. Those were all people that we were in church with on Sunday. They were fine. What happened? Well, maybe what happened is they felt so isolated because instead of the church being a welcoming place where we could come authentically flawed, we felt like we had to cover it up. We felt like we had to pretend to be a professional Christian. Well, I wrote Truth Be Told because I don't want to be a professional Christian anymore. I want to be the first person who says, you know what? I got some messes, but I'm going to dare to believe that there's a God who loves me anyway. And I'm going to dare to believe that there's some other Christians who would love me anyways, even if they knew that I was less than perfect. So I'm putting it out there. Truth be told, and I hope you will too, be honest, be vulnerable, and trust that the Lord is never going to leave your side, and trust that He loves you, and there's going to be people in your path that instead of judging you, they're going to love you, and that is going to be the key to finding true freedom in your life. There's no failure, no fall, there's no sin you don't already know, so let the truth be told.